used to too, but now Cody Camera's way to the outside. So, you know, just, you guys got to think. Just about ready to go green again.
All right. Clap your hands. Fire up your engines. This time, we're going green.
Then it's Daniel Benham, and then the two Warner sleds, Tremblay and Renheim, running 4-5.
The teammates are teamed up and together. Right up front there, the Pirtek sleds of Cam and Peter Narsa. And I'll tell you, nobody in this race, except for Cody Cam, wanted to see what they're seeing right now. That kid can run away.
And then look at that. You've got Tremblay and Renheim, 4-5, their teammates. And right behind them is 6 and 7, Pelaya and Myasishal. All of the teammates bunched out.
Goodness sakes! Was that Renheim that just went around Narsa like he was sitting still?
Yep, 311 and Tremblay's right behind him.
And they drag race towards the Air Force flyaway. For the moment, it's Narsa. But here comes Renheim. The battle for seconds continues.
Inside, big. Watch him. He's going to try set him up here. Narsa probably will go inside. Renheim has been pretty decent at jumping the outside here and then cutting back down underneath.
For the moment, it continues to be the Pirtek sleds and the Pirtek Snocross National. But look at them three abreast right here.
Yeah, there's some rubbing between Benham, and he was going to try to be intimidated by Israel. Benham wanted nothing to do with it.
And there's Logan Christian, who takes the spot.
And that is the battle for 5, 6, and 7.
So the battle continues in the back there as Logan Christian on the 43 does take that fifth spot. There's Elias Ischel. He continues to battle the 221 of Benham.
Yeah, and he's going to probably...
Oh! And that's Logan Christian
off his sled.
Logan Christian just made a great pass into fifth, and now he's off his sled, but there's Elias Ischel taking out the hay bales.
Oh, there's some aggressive driving going on right now, Hawk. Oh! Oh, Ischel just about off.
Let's take a look at what happened here. Logan Christian, but nothing more. And the first thing he says is, hey, I'm laying here.
Yeah, lucky he didn't get hit. That's thankful that everybody was able to get around him. But, you know, just as we cut back to that replay, oh, and look at Cody Cam. Cam gets the back part of his sled kicked out from him.
So it's Cody Cam and Peter Narsa. The man on your camera is the leader. That's the 53 of Cody Cam. And there's Peter Narsa, the 54's in second, but look who's right behind him.
Yeah, Adam Renheim, and right behind Renheim is his teammate. That would be Tim Tremblay. So look for the mean green sleds to be up there soon. Those are the two Makita GMC sleds out of Warner Racing.
So they head for the Air Force flyaway. Narsa on the 54 continues to run second to his teammate. The Pirtek sleds dominating the Pirtek Snocross National here in round 6. But can they hold off those Makita sleds? We've got 11 laps left to find out.
One thing we should look at, and that is Lincoln Lemieux. He got put in the back row. He is now up to 7th place.
They head for the Amsoil finish line to put another lap in the books. They cross that line. Cam Narsa Renheim with 10 laps to go at Canterbury Park.
Cam with about a 1.5-second lead over the field as you watch him go down the Air Force flyaway. Boy, Renheim charging hard, trying to make the pass to get into that second position on the podium. Narsa fighting hard.
Trying every line he can through that Air Force flyaway was Renheim there, but again, still not making up any room on that man. Running second to 54 of Narsa.
10 to go here. Great battles on the racetrack. That's the battle for 2-3. Narsa, Renheim. Like you said, Hunt, Renheim trying every line he can imagine to try to make up some ground. He looks over his shoulder, and who does he see? His teammate, Tim Tremblay.
headed towards the Air Force Flyway. There's the 11 of 10 Tremblay in fourth, and right behind him, here comes your points leader. Elias Ischel is trying to take away a spot from Tim Tremblay. Every point matters when you're running for a championship.
Ischel taking and focusing on the number 11 Skidoo.
Man, is he something else. What an aggressive driver is Elias Ischel. That number 200 sled trying to reel in the 11 on your screen right now. The two teammates in front of him keeping him off the podium for the moment as they put another lap in the books. We've got 8 laps to go in Canterbury Park. There's Tremblay. You see his teammate right in front of him. It's still Cam and Narsa, then Wertheim and Tremblay, and Elias Ischel trying to reel him in. There's the 53 of Cam, and there's Narsa. And he's reeled in his teammates.
And the teammate's doing well, but you know, you talk about Cody Cam. Cody Cam won both of his qualifiers. So he not only gets the regular points, but he gets bonus points. And so coming into this final, he is third in points.
And the stands are filled with Cody Cam and Hitchis Racing fans this afternoon in Shakopee. And they're getting everything they want right now. As we sit here, 2 Pirtek sleds in the lead at the Pirtek Snowcross National.
Boy, a little over a 2-second lead. Cody pulling out a little bit on his teammate. It's still, look at that, there's 2 teammates right behind him too. It's still Wertheim and Tremblay sitting in 3 and 4.
There is your leader out of the Country Cat corner and headed towards the Amsoil finish line again. When he crosses that finish line, there'll be 6 to go for Cody Cam at Canterbury. A little bit of style for Cody Cam.
And there's certain parts of this racetrack that are really getting chewed up. He's taken a couple of hard landings. That one part of the racetrack just about had the rear end of his sled kicked away from him. So, you know, got to ride smart, find good lines.
And Tremblay has made his way once again into another battle with Elias Ischel right there. You see the two racers again. Elias Ischel on the 200 is your points leader coming into tonight. And he wants us to be Narsa.
Who's got a problem?
That's Narsa. Something is wrong with Peter Narsa's sled. He was running second, and now he is off the track. There's his teammate, and suddenly he's vulnerable because Adam Wertheim and Tim Tremblay got nothing but red in their sights as we speak.
Oh, man, they can smell blood in the water here if they can make up some ground to try to charge Cody Cam. You got to remember that both Wertheim and Tremblay, big, strong racers, they're going to want to really push that issue if they can get up to Cody Cam.
But, Mike, right now, Tremblay's got bigger things to worry about. In the form of Elias Ischel, the 200 sled is right on his tail, and he wants that podium spot. That's the battle for third.
Yeah, Tremblay's not going to take and let Elias, try to intimidate him. He knows how to play this game. Look at Ischel on the outside, Tremblay on the inside. That's a good battle.
Yeah, the Jimmy John sled is just freaky fast right now. They come out of the corner and head for the Air Force Flyaway. Elias Ischel, he's going to try the outside line. Can he reel in third? Right now, he tries the outside line again.
Down into the corner. This is where he can try a different line. You've seen that Tremblay went upside off that little kicker. That gave Elias an opportunity to make up some ground. And boy, is he eating roost.
Man, he is. You really can see it there. They come out of the catcher cat corner. Elias Ischel trying to find the third spot from Tim Tremblay. They cross the Amsoil finish line. 3 to go at Canterbury Park. And here comes Ischel.
Ischel looked over his shoulder, seeing what was going on. Going to try to rail around the outside here. And here's the battle up front.
This is for the lead.
Yeah, Wertheim's caught.
Logan Christian is down. You can't pass under yellow, so
look at Wertheim, lets
him back by.
Wertheim, let him go. Let him go back out front. So let's see if he can reel him in again.
Whoa.
He is right there.
Mike, we've got 2.5 laps to go, and this is the battle for the lead. It's Cody Cam. It's Adam Wertheim. They hit the Amsoil finish line. Wertheim to the lead.
Oh, man, what a huge move. Just power down that front straight. Able to make the pass. Now can Cody counter?
Flyaway on the backstretch, and he is your new leader with authority, Mike.
That was just so strong. A big, big move. This is a big driver. Just muscled that sled through the front part of the racetrack. took some rest, but was able to make the pass on Cody Cam.
A lap and a half to go for an M&O. Elias Ishul gets around Tim Tremblay. That's your battle for third.
Look at Tremblay. He wanted to go back down underneath. He was just too close to Ishul. There's your race leader. One lap to go.
The white flag flies for Adam Rindheim. Cody Cam in second. Here comes Ishul. Does he have enough race left to get around for second?
Ishul able to get around Tremblay. Here is Rindheim, your race leader. Almost 2.5 seconds ahead of Cam, but like you said, can Ishul catch Cam? I don't know.
Into the last few turns, the 3:11 of Adam Rindheim. It took him almost 13 laps to find the lead, but he found it. And now he finds the last corner in his sights, out of the Country Cat corner, and headed for the flames. The checkers will fly. Adam Rindheim has won at Canterbury Park. So Rindheim, Cam, and Ishul and Tremblay find a way to give us the best race of the weekend. We'll be right back to talk to our winner at Canterbury Park. This is the CBS Sports Network. Wow. Wow, what a race, Mike. Holy moly, what happened? I mean, Cam had that race won.
You know, I don't know. Did he have sled issues where it fell off a little bit or whatever? It's going to be interesting to hear, his comments in this post-race interview, because he was there. We know that Narsa had a problem. Sometimes they set up the sleds kind of the same. What happened? We may know or we may never know.
Well, and who worked harder than Elias Ishul? He found his way to third, and he had the fastest lap of the race on lap 7, Mike, and that's great. I mean, huge for your points leader.
Yeah, he ran a 38.598. That is, that's moving around.
And the most passes for the night goes to Senior Smiley himself, Kyle Poline. So congratulations to him as well. But my goodness, what a race we just saw at Canterbury Park. So many fans came here tonight. We hope and we believe we can say you got your money's worth thanks to that man right there. Wow. So, Rindheim, Cam, Ishul, your top three. Then Tremblay, Daniel Benham, a strong fifth place for Daniel Benham. Aki Palayan, sixth. Kyle Poline, seventh. Johan Lindman, eighth. Travis Muller, ninth. And tenth with the Corrin tie. Then we've got Brett Nastala, Montana Jess, Lincoln Lemieux, Logan Christian, and Peter Narsa rounding out your top 15. Wow. And, so many times we heard it's hard to pass on this track. Well, I'll tell you what. A bunch of guys found out a lot of ways to do it right there. Got really creative and found a way to win that race.
Yeah, thank you.
What a race for you. It took you almost 13 laps to get to this first place. You had a fun little ending there at the end with a big congratulations. Comment on that race.
Yeah, I didn't look so good there for a while. I was in third. I felt like I was losing ground to the other guys, and Tim, I think, were in fourth. So I was a little bit worried that he will come and mess my speed up, but then I regrouped and I increased the speed and I started to catch the other guys, and I wasn't really sure if the move on Cody was going to work, but it did this time. I'm really, really happy. This is my first win here in the U.S. On the ice hockey race, so I'm really, really happy.
Well, a big congratulations to you. Well deserved.
Thank you.
A fantastic win and a great race. Wow. Adam Rindheim, thank you very much for a fun night. All right. Well, Mike, I think it's time to give him the hardware.
Just let me catch my breath.
All right, let's hand out the hardware for the last time tonight here in the Pro Final. Your third place finisher is out of Oppdal, Norway, racing for Skidoo, Jimmy John's, XPS Oil, FXR, and Boss Racing. Third place goes to the number 200 Skidoo, Elias Ischel. Your second place racer out of Kenosha, Wisconsin, racing for Hinch's Racing out of Shakopee, racing for Polaris, Pirtek, Monster Energy, and FXR. The number 53 Polaris second place, Cody Cam. And your winner, out of Warner Racing, for Makita, Rockstar Energy Drinks, Skidoo, NSK Bearings, and GMC Trucks, from Lima, Sweden, the 311 Skidoo, Adam Renai. Let's go down trackside to Winner's Circle one more time with Josie Christian.
Thanks, guys. Elias, you worked so hard for that third place. You were pushing. You had so much roost from Tremblay there those last couple of laps. How did you push through it?
Yeah, it was so hard. It was hard to see. And I just tried to stay smart and don't do something stupid. And I could pick up some and pass some people. And I came up to third. So, yeah, that's a good weekend for me. And just want to thank my whole team, Boss Racing, for everything they do. And Gary, Max, and Jamie, Jesse, David, just everyone at the team, Aki and Ossi, and just everyone back home that's watching and supporting me, and all the fans, and yeah, Jimmy Jones, FXR, XPS, Sturzboy, CNA Pro Skis, just thank you, everyone. Thank
you. Congratulations. And in second, Cody, let's talk about that race. You had a good day going 1-1, and then you were leading basically that whole entire race, but what was your thought process through it all?
Yeah, I had a great race. I just started making silly line choices, and Adam had better lines and just outraced me out there. And I mean, I was trying. The team has been working their asses off all weekend, all year, and we're finally to a place where I'm happy, and I hope they're happy now. And just like to thank them, Polaris, Hench's Racing, Walker Evans, Monster Energy, FXR, EDS, Pirtek, Ergodyne, Monster Energy, just everybody, huge thanks for getting me up here.
Congratulations. Again, on top of the podium, Adam Renheim, you went out there and dominated that race, saying it was your first win in America. Talk about that a little bit and how much it means to you to be up here.
No, but it means a lot. I have been here a few years now, and I have been waiting and waiting, and when is this going to come? Like, I see other guys, they just pop up from nowhere and win, and I feel like I'm there in the heat races, and I don't get it really together in the finals, but yeah, this day was my day. I liked the wet conditions and the top track. Didn't show that yesterday, but today was revenge.
Hard work always pays off. Who would you like to thank tonight?
No, but of course the whole team, the whole Makita Rockstar team, Skido, NSK, GMC, Quick Trip, XPS Lubricant, and yeah, my mechanics, they work really hard, those guys too, and of course my family, the fans at home, Aline's Shock, Sven-Erik Rebelli from the Shock guy at home, and yeah, just everyone.
Congratulations. A well-deserved top three for the pro.
Fantastic job, and great racing. Thank you, gentlemen, for putting on a fantastic show, and thank you to everybody that came out to Canterbury Park. Mike, any final thoughts?
Well, I tell you what, we've seen some great racing, and you made the comment, you know, if you didn't get your money's worth, I don't know what more we could have done. Yeah. The racing was just incredible. We want to congratulate all the winners, and then again, a couple of people injured a little bit. Our thoughts go out with those folks, too. So, all in all, a great weekend, and I can't wait until we move on to the bullring. In a Deadwood.
Yeah, make sure you keep up with us, ladies and gentlemen, online and all over the places. We do head to Deadwood, South Dakota next. For Brendan Goyne, for Josie Christian, for Mike Schroeder, and for the cast of thousands who put on these fantastic races. My name is Chris Hockey. Thank you so much for coming on out and for tuning in. We'll talk to you from Deadwood, South Dakota in a couple of weeks. Until then, be safe, everybody. God bless and have a great weekend.
Somebody handed you a cup, so you went with the flow and you filled it on up. You feel the buzz in your bones and then you start.